Well, here it is. You've seen it here first, because I'm told it's the only one like it. Custom. De Oliveira. I guess that's how you pronounce that. Made in Brazil. And it doesn't work right. So let's see if we can sort it out. So, we don't like that kind. So when I have a look at the neck, I am told this has two truss rods, which it needs. I can see a little hump here. And this side of the neck looks a little too straight as well. So let's see what we have for string heights. One thing that concerns me slightly is apparently a couple of other technical people have had their hands on this and could not get it to play right. Well, I'm going to just choose the 17th fret just because this is so, or this is where the 17th fret would be. So we've got 664s on the big fat B string, almost 7, which is too much. Then the next one is just as sillily high. String action seems to be set. We're getting there. We got this string set to 5, that one's set to 7. So there's problems here for sure. I'm going to loosen the string tension and let's look under the cover down here and see what we've got for truss rods and see what they do. Well, there they are, and we got a free nut falling off. I don't know, there's a lot of glue there. It's not gluing anything. I'll clean all that off in a second. I'm going to put a straight edge on this. You see, I've got the strings all loosened and pulled out of the way. And we're going to make this straight with no strings on it. No string tension. I haven't adjusted anything. But when I go to the bass side, with my super straight edge, and I look, well, I got a back bow right around the 5th fret. When I go on the treble side, ooh, it gets really crazy. Look at the straight edge. It only touches in like one spot here. So I should have asked if these are two-way truss rods. I'm going to find out. So what we got is serious back bow here, a little bit of back bow here, and that's probably all that quacking noise you hear when you try to play it. Okay, so, well, I'm hoping these are two-way truss rods, because that is absolutely loosened off on the treble side. We'll keep turning it, and hopefully it catches the other way. Yeah, honey, oh goodness. Our happy days are here again. And same with the bass side. Let's just see what happens. Do they work nicely? This won't be too bad, but you got to start somewhere, right? Before you add string tension. Am I getting a reflection there? Where's me? Skinny feeler gauge. This is 4/1000ths of an inch, by the way. I'm going to call that straight on that side. Okay, the neck now is straight. Without string tension. Let me clean this up. No idea what happened there. Don't want to know. Well, I'm almost got it cleaned up. I can't believe how much glue is in there. And unfortunately, this isn't really part of the setup. But I couldn't not fix it. It just sort of fell off and was glued in like shit. I had to pull out a lot of stuff to clean that up. So, first of all, the actual channel where this sits wasn't really cut right. So whoever installed this tried to fill up the shit with glue. This, sorry if my hand's moving, I'm trying to keep, this is meant to float up and down. Well, you don't want any glue on that surface, do you? That was like covered with crap. So I will put two tiny dots of CA glue. Even though this is wood, if I glue wood on wood, this will never ever come off. Well, it'll come off, but in pieces. So we're going to do two blobs of CA glue and hold that where it needs to go, and then hit it with a bit of accelerator, and that is going to be it. Okay, let's put the strings back on it to pitch and see what it's going to pitch. Well, it's tuned up. How's this go again? B, A, D, G, C. All right, now. What I did notice, though, is it's got all these controls that do nothing. And except that one turns every... active, passive. That, I got one volume and squat. So either it's got a dead battery or no battery. Let's look. Well, that's kind of interesting because I didn't take those screws out. Yeah, there's a big pile of spaghetti and a place for a wire or a battery and some foam, and I don't think I have a new 9-volt, so I'll leave it up to the guy that owns it, but I will find four screws to keep that from falling off. I did not remove those. All right, now, back to the truss rod adjustment game show. What I did notice before I even went any farther, this adjustable nut thing set way too low, so still not sure if I really think it's where it should be. Base side seems okay. Treble side still needs to come up a bit. Unfortunately, you gotta loosen everything off and retune. Let's play truss rod Wheel of Fortune. Okay, so here's, and I hope maybe we get a little better camera angle on that for you guys. You really, on a guitar that has one truss rod, you have one relief, right? On this one, I want to be able to measure it on both sides. This is a 34-inch scale. So to get my hands around this and have a measure, see, right now, after I set that neck straight with no string tension, that seems pretty good. I know it's a good shot of my elbow. Let's see what's going on the treble side. Oh, 7. I don't mind that at all. What's my eyeball say? It's usually how I start, is with my eyeball. Well, I don't hear any more of that nonsense, but let's just revisit this again. Let's revisit the string height now that we seem to have straightened the neck out. That's now sitting at 6. I'm going to try for 5. That's almost 7. They're all different, so give me a minute and I'll get them all the same. That's a good start. Well, it's now in the laps of the gods. Why does one string, I don't know, I got, maybe it isn't in the laps of the gods yet. Why does that just, because of the way the fingerboard is, it's just so flat. Weird. Yeah, I think we got it sussed here now. Yeah. Okay. I don't hear any more of that quack quack that we had. I don't know how what you play, or you play stuff on it, I guess. Anyway, the great links to all things are below. What is, you saw it here, whatever that says, the Oliveira. Vieira. They have a website. It's too small for me to read. Handmade Brazilian wood. No kidding. Oh, no. Don't tell me. Oh, I was going to say. Yeah, it's a puzzle. It's a puzzle. Get yourself back on your spot there. Oh, yeah. Don't let me forget the four screws that are old in the back, which I didn't take those out of there. So somebody's got them. Yeah, the links to things are below. A great shout out to all my patrons, as always, for helping me keep this going. Father's Day is coming. I'm hoping there's going to be like a miraculous conception, and some childlike object will buy me something nice. My video camera, I'm down to my last video camera. When I started YouTube, I had three. Now I'm down to one. Make that leap when I have to. So that's it. Don't forget my buddy Fred, his YouTube channel with all the recording schwas, Red Shoes there, Professor Red Shoes. What else? Get a sticker, get a Penny Black CD, subscribe, become a patron. Join the Facebook group. I am going to put up a new Facebook page very soon, once I get some motivation to do that, only to watch it get yanked down. People are asking how to get a hold of me. I am in the Toronto area, east end of Toronto, so that works out for you. I do not accept guitars for repair via shipping in any way, shape, or form. Unless you're shipping it to me in your car or your girlfriend's car or whatever it is. Anyway, folks, I am just going to let the guy know that this is as good as I can do with it. Anything else that's not right with this from the future, and I was explaining that, it's all about these two truss rods. If this is set. This is not going to change. The string heights are now set correctly. This, that adjustable nut, that wasn't set. It was too low on the treble side, and it had a hump in the neck on the treble side, and that's why it really wasn't playing very well. The rest is up to the player. Anyway, folks, be good, be safe. Cheers.